NBC2's Alex Howard reports police think he sells it as scrap metal, pocketing the cash.
For some local body shop owners here in Cape Coral, these thefts don't come as a surprise. In fact, they say scrap collectors are so common that they can put out a rear fender like this one from a car at the curb, and it'll be gone by the next day.
Well, we're a body shop. We change parts, we fix parts.
As a body shop owner, Greg Kremsky ends up with a lot of twisted, useless metal.
Basically, whenever we replace a metal part, we keep it in a separate pile. We like to recycle to be green.
But more often than not, he says there's no shortage of people eager to do the recycling for him.
Every day, someone's driving down the alley with a trailer and trucks, and some of the guys are fighting over the scrap if it's there. They'll dumpster dive.
That's because recyclers will often pay by the pound for scrap metal, meaning some will go to great lengths to find it.
There are people that know what they can do within the law, and then, of course, these guys, they're working outside the law, so we're working on catching them.
So it didn't come as a surprise when two different industrial businesses in Cape had metal stolen, one losing $500 worth of aluminum and the other $1,000 worth of copper wire.
There's several places they can sell it. There are places that will take scrap metal. Legitimately, of course. You're supposed to own that legitimately, whether it was yours from a project. If it's left at the side of the road, that's pretty much fair game, too.
But Cape Police say the metal collected by this man and SUV wasn't legit, and now they want help tracking it down.
They can't afford to lose that, nor even if they could afford to lose it, they shouldn't. You're taking something that's not yours. That's theft.
In Cape Coral, Alex Howard, NBC2.
A man who's